Welcome to this short video about possibility of classification the types of utilities networks on the GPR images. My name is Klaudia ONYSZKO and I'm a research assistant on Military University of Technology in Warsaw. The problems that have arisen with the classification of network types are detection efficiency, which means that not only true hyperbolas was detected. What is the true and false hyperbolas? True hyperbolas representing the potential occurrence of utilities networks. False hyperbolas are the objects which are not an underground utilities. The second problem refers to completeness of hyperbolas. Because we based on the geometric features of hyperbolas, it's hard to analyze hyperbolas only with the vertex or with the vertex and the left or right arm. And the last main problem was classifying false objects, which not represent utilities networks. The analysis of the possibilities of object classification must be preceded by image preprocessing, filtration and extraction of true hyperbolas. The proposed method of hyperbola detection is based on converting the RGB image to grayscale, background removal, edge detection, fitting the object into the set of the detected pixels and selecting only those hyperbolas that meet the predefined condition size, curvature and depth of the object. Geometric features show the geometric properties of objects in the image and are related to their shape. We propose to analyze the true hyperbolas on the basis of the following features: curvature, size, completeness and symmetry of the hyperbola, width and height, depth, thickness of the hyperbola and the signal length. One of these features of hyperbola was acquired not from the image, but from the signal, which is a one-dimensional data. To get a signal of hyperbola, we need to reduce the two-dimensional image into one-dimensional signal using the ring projection technique. In this figure, we can see examples of the visual representation of different types of underground networks and its hyperbolic representation after binarization process. We can see that some of these hyperbolas aren't complete. So it's hard to compare, for example, size of hyperbolas when we have complete or sometimes half of hyperbola. For this reason, the hyperbola characteristics were classified into three groups: complete object, nearly complete objects, and incomplete objects. The proposed methodology for the classification of objects is based on multi-criteria optimization. We developed the classification coefficients, which automates and supports the process of detecting and identifying underground utility networks by inexperienced operators. For the results obtained with algorithm, the following ranges are proposed for the classification of the object detected in the radar gram: certain point, uncertain point, and least certain point. The proposed algorithm of automatic detection of true hyperbolas allows for their detection with the efficiency from about 79% to about 99% with respect to the reference data from national geodetic and cartographic resources. The effectiveness of hyperbolic classification was respectively about 58% for certain object, about 39% for uncertain object, and about 48% for least certain object. The performed analyses are the basis for future research on possibilities of classification of network types on the basis of GPR images. Thank you for watching this video.